We all know we are living through an unprecedented climate crisis, which is truly aggravated by the pollution from gasoline vehicles. It is thanks to companies like Tesla that this global problem is slowly being quelled. Tesla was founded in 2003 with the main objective of providing a solution to this problem. The goal was to create zero-emission electric vehicles, to gradually replace gasoline cars, and consequently improve the environmental situation. Today, Tesla is classified as the company with more sales in the electric car sector, with a market share of 20%. Tesla's current CEO, Elon Musk, is the longest tenured CEO of any manufacturer of automobiles worldwide, and the fifth richest person in the world. Tesla's business model is radically different to most of the companies, since the American company owns the entire supply chain of its product, from manufacturing to distribution. This approach is motivated by the overall objective of reducing manufacturing costs and cost of goods sold, thereby guaranteeing the company's survival and sustainability. Tesla's growth strategy is primarily based on research and development, as this section occupies about 50% of the company's expenses. It is precisely thanks to this investment that the company has been able to present pioneering and innovative models to the automotive market, such as the Tesla Model X or the new Tesla Model S. The goal at the production level, according to Tesla CEO Elon Musk, is to increase the level of production and perhaps in the near future get to produce the energy that makes its cars function. Tesla's inventory management strategy is to reduce as much the inventory as possible. By maintaining a very small inventory, the costs for the company are lower, and therefore the profit is larger. To carry out this type of strategy, Tesla only produces the cars once they have been paid by the customers. In this way, the company minimizes the risk of having a large inventory, which may not be sold. The money saved by avoiding excess inventory is invested in research and development. We are talking about an optimal and totally efficient management model.
Management accounting, contrary to financial accounting, is what helps internal actors, meaning the managers, to coordinate product design, production, and make marketing decisions, as well as evaluate a company's performance. But it also helps them develop, communicate, and implement new strategies. Every company needs to have a strategy. It will specify how the organization matches its own capabilities with the opportunities in the marketplace. It also describes how organizations create value for their customers and distinguish themselves from its competitors. There are two different types of strategies a company may follow. The first one is the cost leadership strategy, which is low prices at a good quality. The second one is product differentiation strategy, which are unique products at a higher premium price. Managers have to decide between these strategies, and they use strategic cost management to do it. Strategic cost management describes cost management that specifically focuses on strategic issues. In the case of Tesla, they use a product differentiation strategy. They offer high-quality, innovative, unique electric sports cars at premium prices. To create value for their customers, Tesla directs many resources into research and development, to make sure that the customers feel like their money is being well spent. Tesla also focuses on every key success factor. They work in their cost efficiency, in their quality, in their time, which meaning new product development time and customer response time, also innovation and sustainability. Tesla seems to care so much about sustainability in the environmental aspect that they have decided to put down their patents in order for their competitors to use their technology and help end the carbon crisis. This will be discussed later. Overall, Tesla uses its money to build high-performance cars. Specifically, it heavily invests on their battery. Moreover, they sustain the largest manufacturing plant in the world for mass
production. Decision-making is a fundamental skill for any successful executive, but decisions at the strategic level are hard to make. They involve long-term consequences that are difficult to predict, and they require considering multiple strategic objectives which are hard to balance, particularly in the presence of risk and uncertainty. Analyzing the decision-making process, accountants have discovered five steps that do always happen. In the first place, managers must identify the problem and uncertainties within their companies and the market itself. Secondly, information must be obtained in order to gain a better understanding of these problems. The third step is the creation of predictions for the future based on the information previously gathered. In the fourth place, the decision is made by deciding among the alternatives. And finally, the decision is implemented and the performance is evaluated, and this way the firm gets a deeper understanding of the functioning of the market. Let us now focus on one of the numerous decisions made by Tesla during its history in order to have a look on the functioning of this five-step decision-making process. In 2016, the company only counted with two models. These are the Tesla Model S and the Tesla Model X. By analyzing their audience, they discovered that it was made barely in its fullness by an older high class. Despite this, Tesla's planned target audience was wider, and they studied how to attract millennials. This is due to the fact that Tesla does not just seek profit, and as its mission statement claims, Tesla's mission is to accelerate the world transition to sustainable energy. In the first place, they identified their problem, the lack of consumption by the younger audience. They studied this sector of society and their characteristics. Afterwards, they created different predictions of the future and different alternative strategies. And the result of this decision-making process was that Tesla Model 3 launched in 2017. By reducing the size of the touchscreen display, among other features, they achieved a price of $35,000, being thus more accessible to millennials.
Now I'm going to talk about Tesla's cost by first defining what a cost is. A cost is a resource sacrificed or foregone to achieve a specific objective. It is usually measured as the monetary amount that must be paid to acquire goods or services. When you think of a cost, you think of it in the context of putting a price on a particular thing. We call this thing a cost object. For example, Tesla's Model X. Now, let's wonder how Tesla determines the cost of various cost objects. It does so in two stages, accumulation followed by assignment. Cost accumulation is the collection of data in some organized way by means of an accounting system. After being accumulated, the costs are then assigned to designated cost objects, such as the different models of cars that Tesla manufactures. Tesla managers use this cost information in two main ways. First, when making decisions. Second, for implementing decisions by influencing and motivating employees to act. There are two major cost classifications, direct and indirect costs, variable and fixed cost. Direct costs of a cost object are related to the cost object and can be traced to it in an economically feasible way. A good example could be the cost of steel tires of Tesla's Model X. Indirect costs of a cost object are related to the particular cost object, but cannot be traced to it in an economically feasible way. An example could be the salaries who oversee the production of the different types of cars. Variable and fixed costs. Fixed costs are expenses that remain constant for a period of time irrespective of the overall output. Variable costs are expenses that change directly and proportionally to the changes in business activity, level, or volume. Identifying a cost as variable or fixed provides valuable information for making many management decisions.
Inventoryable cost, also referred to as product cost, consists of direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead. These are all the manufacturing costs that need to be incurred in order for the product to exist, and are all directly related to the making of the final good. Direct materials are traceable from the final product, as they are directly used for the production of the finished product. Here are some examples of inventoryable costs in Tesla. Some of examples of direct materials of Tesla are the steel used for the doors, roof, and car mold, the rubber for the wheels, the plastic for the inside of the car, the floor mats, the air conditioner vents, and the airbags and aluminum. Secondly, direct labor is everything in relation to the manufacturing and building of the goods or service. For example, an example of direct labor is a guy cutting steel in a steel plant, people who assemble the car and help manufacture the car, and wages of the labor employees. Lastly, manufacturing overhead costs, also known as the indirect production cost, consists of all the other manufacturing costs that are not direct material and labor. For example, indirect materials, factory utilities, depreciation of factory buildings, and equipment. This can also be glue sheets for the car, which is an indirect material. All of the other costs, unrelated to the inventoryable cost, are also known as the period cost. Period costs are non-traceable costs from the finalized product, and therefore cannot be reported as expenses, inventory, or fixed asset. Therefore, period costs include all non-manufactured costs, which are research and development, administrative cost, marketing, selling, and financial cost. One main area Tesla focuses on is the research and development sector. Examples of Tesla's research are as follows. The Tesla company conducting surveys to gather information to further develop the progress of the technology on their projects, as well as the engineers working to better the technology included in the Tesla cars, for example, with the test drives in the autopilot.
The Tesla company has shown to be completely committed to the environment and does it in a not selfish way. At first, Tesla patented all their inventions and technology that they were developing. But after a few years of its creation, the company has realized that the philosophy of the company goes against this. The fact of creating patents to avoid competition with other car manufacturers may benefit Tesla, but this would put a brake on the development of electric cars. Therefore, Tesla has decided to eliminate all its patents, and those who hope to make the electric automotive sector advance at a much faster rate. The company has realized that it is even more beneficial for them to eliminate patents, since the fact that other companies increase their manufacture of electric cars can make people start preferring an electric car over a combustion one. What Tesla is really trying to achieve is accelerate the transition from combustion cars to electric cars, and thus combat the carbon crisis. This philosophy, according to Tesla, tried to favor a sustainable development platform from which the whole world will benefit from. Tesla's change of philosophy has been very well seen by the automotive world, and especially by the environmental organizations. But on the other hand, some people specialized in business have described this action by Tesla as something good for humanity, but bad for business. However, the company has not stopped growing since its creation, and its vehicle production has increased a lot, year after year. It is true that some models have not been very successful, and this has reduced the company's profits a bit, but the company is still leading the sector. Tesla's philosophy is based on the fact that history has shown that development has been achieved through cooperation and working together and not through imposing difficulties on other companies. Tesla tries to optimize its business model, and part of these optimizations is due to the promotion of renewable energy and collaborating, so that the training of engineers increases, the production of cars increases, the provision of car charging cities increases, and for many other things.
In conclusion, the role of management accounting is a key aspect in Tesla's model. It influences their product differentiation strategy, their decision-making process, like when they decided to expand their line of products, or when deciding to invest in research and development and marketing, as well as assigning prices to their cars. They have demonstrated to be a successful brand, even with high competition, by focusing on the key aspects of success. However, in 2014, they made the bold decision of removing patents in their technology, saying that it was worth it for environment. In the words of the founder, Elon Musk, Tesla will not initiate patent lawsuits against anyone who, in good faith, wants to use our technology. Since this happened, it appears the company has continued to grow. Why do you think this is the case? Was sustainability the only reason behind this decision? What do you think about their strategy in assigning costs? Let us have a discussion about these things. Thank you very much.